Hi, my name is David Stewart, and I'm a Security Solutions Architect with Micro Focus Fortify. Today, we're going to be reviewing how to integrate your Software Security Center environment with JIRA for bug and defect tracking. Fortify supports several bug trackers out of the box, including Bugzilla, Micro Focus ALM and Quality Center, JIRA, Team Foundation Server, and VSTS, which are better known as Microsoft DevOps now. While the general process for configuring a bug tracker with Software Security Center is going to be similar for each of these applications listed below, there may be slight variations in some of the configuration settings. To learn more, you can visit our Fortify Software Security Center documentation set, which is available as a part of your product downloads or on the Micro Focus documentation listed behind you. If you're interested in learning more about our other ecosystem integrations, including IDE plugins, build servers, and more, you can visit our marketplace website at marketplace.microfocus.com/fortify. The Fortify Bug Tracker plugins are not enabled by default in Software Security Center, so the first thing we need to do to get started is go and enable those inside the administration section of your Software Security Center environment, and we want to come down here and expand the Plugins tab and select Bug Tracking. Now, you won't have anything listed here by default, so we need to add the jar file that Fortify ships for each of the Bug Tracker integrations by coming in here and selecting New, accepting the acknowledgement, and then locating the plugin bundle jar file. For JIRA, the name of the jar file is com.fortify.bugtracker-plugin-jira7-18.20.jar, and we want to go ahead and start that upload. If you downloaded the Fortify ISO or the Fortify SSC server file from your entitlements page, you can locate these plugin files inside the Fortify 18 Server War Tomcat, and in there, there is a plugins folder. The plugins folder is going to house each of the individual jar files for the bug trackers that we support. Once the plugin has been uploaded into SSC, you'll notice that it is disabled by default. We want to go ahead and click on this line item. It will expand and we'll be given the option to enable it inside our SSC environment. Now that we've added the bug tracker, we can come and configure the integration between an individual application in Software Security Center and that same application profile inside JIRA. Fortify does support use of multiple bug tracking systems inside a single SSC environment. So if you have some groups who are using JIRA and others who are using another system like Bugzilla or VSTS, each of those individual applications can be configured with a bug tracker that's best suited for the development group that's working on those apps. To get started, we're going to come and click into one of our application profiles in Software Security Center. And then on the right-hand corner of the screen, you'll see a profile button with a little briefcase. We want to go ahead and select that element. And then in the following screen, you'll see a bug tracker tab. Go ahead and select bug tracker. Now this will pull up a drop-down menu. By default, no bug tracker integration will be enabled, but if you follow the last step successfully, you should now have an option for JIRA. Once we've selected JIRA, we then need to provide details about our JIRA instance so that we can successfully make the connection between Software Security Center and JIRA. Next, I'm going to go to my JIRA instance to grab my URL for the connection string. We're going to go ahead and paste that URL into the Bug Tracker URL field. And then for the configuration for JIRA, we're looking for both an allowed and default project type that we want to associate this application version with, as well as an allowed and default issue type. JIRA uses project keys, and that is what we are looking for in these first two fields. The allowed and default project key in JIRA that we're associating the application with. Your issue type will vary depending on how your project has been configured inside JIRA. I have a bug issue type as what I want these issues to be submitted as, so I'm going to put that as both the allowed and default issue type here. Finally, we do want to validate our connection before we apply this. So click on the Validate Connection button, and here we're going to enter the username and password for our JIRA instance. Go ahead and click the Test button and make sure that we're able to get a successful connection here. Finally, you do have the option to enable bug state management on this page. Bug state management allows SSC to make specific updates to bugs inside of JIRA, depending on if the state of the defects that have been submitted have changed. You can learn more about bug state management in Chapter 8 of the Software Security Center User Guide. Once we've finished our configuration, we do want to come down to the bottom and apply these settings. I'm going to get a warning because I've previously set up my bug tracker before, but you will not see that. We'll then get a success message that says the bug tracker has been configured successfully. We can go ahead and close the profile button, and now we're ready to submit issues into JIRA. There are several ways to submit findings from Fortify into your bug tracking system. You can select multiple issues on the left-hand side here. In this case, I'm selecting some of the critical cross-site scripting reflected vulnerabilities. And you'll now notice that there's a new icon on the right-hand corner of the screen with a little bug. If you hover over it, it says File Issues. This is the defect tracking submission system. You can submit one or a group of issues into JIRA. If you select multiple issues and select this at the same time, this is going to submit one bug that has the details around each of these three selected findings. So we'll go ahead and click on that. We're going to go ahead and be prompted to log in with our username and password. If you've previously logged in, it might skip that step, and you'll see the screen that I'm presented here. The bug tracking fields inside JIRA, this is going to give you a summary of the information that's going to populate the specific bug issue type that we're submitting into JIRA. You'll first see the project and the issue type that we submitted inside our profile configuration settings. And then you're going to see some variable attributes for what's going to populate the summary, the description, and then you can optionally select an individual component, a priority level, labels, or any other criteria you have for your issue types inside JIRA. If you're interested in customizing what gets displayed in the description section, you can choose the Show Variable tabs, which will populate a list of specific issues you can see for a certain finding. Once you're pleased with what's going to populate that JIRA ticket, you can go ahead and click the Submit button, and this will go ahead and send these issues off to JIRA. I'm going to go ahead and do one more example of just one specific finding to show you how submitting an individual issue versus a group of issues will affect what's populated in the defect. In this case, I'm selecting the SQL injection. You could also open this up in the Expanded View tab, and you'll see a new file bug link for this specific finding as well. It operates in exactly the same way. You'll be presented with your username and password field, or if that's been cached, the same information will be available where you can customize the summary, the description tab, and any of the other field values inside your JIRA instance. We'll go ahead and click Submit. Once inside JIRA, you can then open up your project. I'm going to come to that Rich's RWI project, and we'll now see two new bugs have been submitted. One for the group of cross-site scripting vulnerabilities. This isn't going to include a deep link back to the issue inside Software Security Center, and we're going to have one deep link for each of the individual cross-site scripting issues that was submitted. Here, we can also see the file name where those cross-site scripting issues occurred. For the individual issue we submitted, we have more details. This is going to be similar to the information you'd have in your vulnerability abstract. We're going to have the vulnerability category, the location of the file where that vulnerability exists, and then a description with that vulnerability abstract data, which does include a deep link back to the issue in Software Security Center as well. I'll also note you can submit defects directly from the IDE plugins. The configuration is going to be a little bit similar. When you select an issue inside your audit workbench, Eclipse, Visual Studio, or IntelliJ IDE, you will see a file bug icon on the issue summary pane. Here, you can set up your integration with ALM, Bugzera, JIRA, TFS, or VSTS, and submit a defect in much the same way. Finally, the last thing you'll notice is that inside your Software Security Center environment, you'll now notice there is a View Bug link on the right-hand side. This is going to show you which issues you submitted defects for. If you go ahead and click on that link, it'll open up that specific finding inside your JIRA instance. More information is available on our bug tracking integrations in the Fortify Software Security Center documentation. Specifically, you can reference the SSC User Guide, Chapter 8. If you have other questions or comments, you can also reach out to our Fortify technical support for additional assistance. Please like and subscribe this channel and check out any of the other videos for the latest and greatest features from Fortify's application security portfolio. Thank you. We'll be right back.